Hey guys, Tegan from Eufabulous here. Today we're doing the second video in our skincare series. We've already covered skin type and skin concern. In today's video, we are covering how to read product labels. There are some very important things that you need to know on skincare labels, so let's get straight into it. Today we're just going to be having a look at my Pixi by Petra Clarity Tonic. This is my one. You can see I'm nearly out. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to start with the front. This is the front of the label here. So all brands, usually on the front of products, you'll usually see, they usually have their brand name. They will also then have the name of the product. They will also then list some of their key ingredients on the front. So you can see here salicylic acid and probiotics are their key ingredients. This is what they are marketing the product with and using those ingredients there as selling points of that specific product. More on that in a minute. Next, you'll find the size down the bottom there. And usually that will be displayed in fluid ounces as well as mils. And we're just going to go to the bottom quickly. So on the bottom of products, sometimes this will be on the side, you'll see the batch number. So all products will have a batch number. Sometimes it won't be displayed on the bottom. Sometimes it'll be on the back of the product. You can see here with the La Mav one is displayed here. Yeah, and usually if the product does have an expiry, it'll be around where that batch code is. So it'll usually be on the bottom or on the back or side of the product. Now we're going to take a look at the back of the product where the good stuff is. So on the back of the product, you'll typically find the description of the product as well as how to use it, followed on by the ingredients. Products that come in a box, a lot of the time you'll find they will leave off the ingredients list. So you'll need to check it on the actual box or the product. So this one here has listed all the ingredients there, whereas when you open up the box and look at the product in the box, see on the back, it doesn't have the ingredients anywhere. It's just got the description and how to use. And you'll also see here, this one had the batch number and expiry on the back. This one has the batch number and expiry on the base of the product. Okay, so back to the ingredients. I'm going to put everything here so you can clearly see what I am talking about without me having to hold up the product to the camera. So with the ingredients are listed from highest concentration down to lowest concentration in that product. So the ingredients being used as a selling point are listed at the bottom of the list. That means that they don't have a high concentration in that product and you're not going to get as much benefit from them as opposed to if they are listed at the top. That means that they have a higher level of concentration and they're more active and they're going to do more for your skin. So if they are using, for example, salicylic acid on here and it's showing on the bottom, you know that it doesn't have such a high concentration in it, that's really going to be doing much for your skin. Whereas when I look at this one here, the two key ingredients that they list as their selling point, salicylic acid and probiotics. If I turn to the back, you'll see it here. Lactobacillus ferment lysate filtrate, that is probiotic. It is listed in one of the first few ingredients on there. And then go down and just two after that is salicylic acid, which means that they are in a higher quantity in this product, which means that they are a good selling point for the product because they are in a higher concentration. Okay, the products down the bottom, a lot of the time, some of them are preservatives to make sure to extend your shelf life of your product. The other really important thing on products, so ingredients is probably the most important. That's also where you can double check any of the ingredients list. It's good to know what you're putting on your skin. The other important thing you will notice on all skincare as well as makeup usually is the little open jar symbol. I will put it here again. So the open jar symbol is a picture of a jar and it usually has a number and an M after it. So what that is, it is a PAO, which stands for period after opening symbol. Okay, so that is how long you have once you open the product to use the product up. Once that period is been, once you reach that period, so say this one here says 9 months, even 9 months time after I first started using it and opened it, even 9 months time, I still have some left, I'm best to discard it because that means that the product is past its, you know, use by date or period after opening date. So if it is a product that you don't think that you will use up in the time frame that they're given, so those numbers vary. They can be 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, 12 months, 36 months, 48 months. They list exactly there how many months you have. So if it is a product that you feel like you won't use up in that time period, what I recommend doing is taking a Sharpie and just writing on somewhere on the label or on the bottle the date that you opened it, just so you have reference for yourself to know when you should be discarding it. So that is how you read skincare product labels. Really simple, really. Just remember, ingredients listed highest concentration to lowest concentration, and that little symbol is the period after opening. So definitely make sure you use those products up within that period. So they are the most important things for the skincare label. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!